to Enots Engineering. I'm Alan. In today's video, we start with a bit more information about turning tapers using the boring head. And then we move on to how to improve the finish of the part that you're turning, depending on what tool you're using and the speed and feeds. We look at using an insert, carbide insert, and also high-speed steel tool, and see the differences when they're set at the same speed on the same piece of steel and the finishes you get. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. What I forgot to mention on last week's video was when you're using the boring head to turn a taper, it's important that you get the top of the head here parallel to your cross slide, because if you put the head in at an angle like that, what happens is as you extend the head further out, you slowly take the part that you're turning either above centre or below centre of your cutting tool. So if you make sure that the top of the slide is dead parallel to your cross slide, then you know your tool will still be on centre line when you're cutting. And once you've put your boring head in the tailstock, the easiest way to check if this is square or parallel to the... let's put a bar in, this is a ground bar. And then you can run a dial indicator over the top here, each side, and then adjust it to get it parallel, and then just tap it home. What I want to do today is just have a look at the difference the tool will make, the type of tool you use when cutting, to the finish you get. I had a comment saying that a lot of my turning, the finish looks a bit rough on there, and that they can turn and get a nice shiny finish. Well, that depends on a lot of things really: the speed, the material, the tool, and the cut. So what I was going to do is just machine this bar, use the same speed, the same feed rate for cutting. I think on this at the moment it's set to 0.2 millimeter per rev, which is about 8 thou. So if you use the same feed rate and the same speed, but all I will do is change the tools. We'll use this one, which I used last week, which is the insert. And then I've found out an old tool that I had, this one, which is high speed steel. So we'll compare the difference we get between an insert and our high speed steel tool. I've set them both to center line. The other thing I want to do is do different cuts. I know if you're using an insert and you only want to take a couple of thou off, you'll lose the finish, because these inserts like to be worked, where with high speed steel you should be able to maintain the finish. So let's do a cut with this insert. Well, that's just touching at the moment, so we'll put a cut on of 0.25, put the travers on. You can see there that looks a rough finish, and it is. So if I go back, so I'll start that again. I'll put a cut on of 0.25. Start again. And you see when it hits this where it's not cut, it should give a better finish. See that very clearly. This part here, it's taken off a lot more than this end. The finish on this end is rough. This is a bit better because we're working the tool more, taking more off. Let me take it right down to the depth there. Let's try the high speed steel tool. It's going in 0.25. I think you can see at this end, it's a lot better finish. It's still what I would call rough, you can feel the grooves in it, but it looks a lot better. So let's just go in another 0.25, try it again. So looking at that, high speed steel has given a better finish than the insert, which is what I would have expected. The insert likes to take off a lot more material. Now if I zoom in on that, now I'm zoomed in as close as I can get to that, so that's probably magnified the finish. It's not too bad. It has got lines on it, you can feel the grooves. but it looks okay. So what I need to do probably is
slow the traverse down so it doesn't travel so far per revolution.
Okay, I've changed my traverse feed to 5 thou per rev, or 0.125. Let's see if that makes any difference. There's the finish on that. It is a bit smoother. Not much difference, but it looks better than it was before. If I go back to the take a cut with the insert and see what finish you get with that. Now this is rougher now, you can see that although it's rubbing rather than cutting, because I can feel this bar has got hot. So on that one I would say mild steel, speed about 850. What you must remember as well, as the diameter gets smaller, there's less surface speed. Your cutting speed is actually slowing down.
So you need to play around with the tool speeds and feeds to get the best finish you can. This is a finish with the carbide insert. This finish was using the high speed steel tool. Another carbide insert finish. And finally, the high speed steel tool finish. And I think high speed steel gives a better finish for the speeds and feeds I was using on the mild steel. It's difficult to show the surface finish on video, but I hope that was useful. Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next week on Enots Engineering.